Shalom, first I want to give all praises, all the glory, the honor to Yahweh, Bashem Yal Shai, double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone, the rule world, the source is truth, and blessings to the elect nation Israel who are scattered worldwide. This is Brother Yukal coming with a short video on Lord willing, your brothers and sisters will be edified. Today's lesson is on the coconut trial. I kid you not. Yes. I kid you not. In the UK, there was a trial that concluded recently, and it was titled the Coconut Trial. All right. And it was an Elamite woman, an Asian woman, who basically, I'll show you. All right. We had this guy, Rishi Sunak, who was the last Prime Minister of the UK, like a president, you know, in America. And he is Indian. He's born and raised here. His parents are of Indian descent. All right. And then in his cabinet, he had a woman called Suella Braverman, this woman here. Okay. Suella Braverman, she is of Indian descent as well. I'm not sure. She might be, let's try and get her background. All right, Suella Braverman's background. She's married to an Edomite man anyway. All right, who's an Amalekite, I think. All right, okay, let's look at Suella Braverman. Was born in Harrow and grew up in Wembley. Okay, my goodness me, man. All right, so she is, there she is, Suella Braverman. All right, let's read up about her. Yes, this is what I thought. In East Africa, you had many Indians who were in countries like Kenya and Uganda, and they had their own businesses and so forth. And even in Africa, all right, even in places like Uganda and Kenya, they were kicked out. In like, you know, maybe the late 60s and 70s, you know, a guy, Idi Amin, kicked them out because he said that they were racist. They looked down upon blacks. And a lot of them did. There's a woman on TV on this program in the morning called Jeremy Vine. And she is one of them. She's a descendant of Indians that were from Uganda. And she admits it. She said Indians thought they were better than the blacks. All right, they got kicked out. All right, now she's from, as she says, her parents are from Kenya and Mauritius. All right, so she's Indian as well. All right, and in the Bible, they're called Elamites. And she was a part of Rishi Sunak's cabinet. And she was the home, I think she was one of the, a home secretary. And she was the one that wanted to deport asylum seekers to Rwanda. And before that, you had a woman called Priti Patel, this woman. Priti Patel. She was the last Home Secretary, all right? Again, of Indian descent. You can see her name, Patel. And she basically stood on a platform of... the UK is for people in the UK, and we should, you know, deport asylum seekers to Rwanda. Okay, now why am I highlighting these things? Because it sets the blueprint for this trial, and this trial was called the Coconut Trial. All right, and you had this woman here, all right, who's an Elamite woman. She, I think, did a protest at Palestine March. And she had a placard showing Rishi Sunak and Suella Braverman, the former Home Secretary, as coconuts, all right? And the reason why I'm highlighting this is because this has everything to do, unfortunately, with the mindset that many of our people are in. So let's get a little background of this trial, okay? Because it's scriptural, because there's no one that has been destroyed more than our people, all right, mentally, So there's a lot of self-hatred going on in the mindsets of our people. Okay? There's a lot. Okay? And therefore, they are what? Coconuts, man. Okay?
Charged with committing a racially aggravated offence for her
Ridiculous.
placard depicting Rishi Sunak and Suella Braverman as coconuts. But today in court, she was found not guilty.
Good.
It goes without saying that this ordeal has been agonising for my family and I. Instead of enjoying my pregnancy, I've been vilified in the media, I've lost my career, I've been dragged through the court system in what can only be described as a politically motivated show trial.
This is a case with cultural and political significance that started here last November. As hundreds of thousands gathered to call for a ceasefire in Gaza, Suella Braverman, the Home Secretary at the time, condemned these protests as a hate march. Her words followed negative remarks about Pakistani men.
There you go. So listen, she is an Elamite herself. And the protests that were happening for the people in Gaza. And look, we don't give a good goddamn about those people. We care about the ones of our people that are among them. Because there's many Palestinians that are Israelites. All right? We care about them. And we care about the ones that the Lord is going to be with. The ones that are part of that elect, that remnant that's going to be saved. You know, because the Lord said, I'll have mercy on who I have mercy on. Okay? And our people are among them. You know? And people were protesting. And this woman... All right. It was the Home Secretary, and she said that those marches were hate marches. You know, I mean, you can't make this up. But why did she do it? Because she was serving her master. That's the point of this video. All right. She was serving her master. All right. And basically, and she's an embarrassment by her community. Even a pharmacist that he's not there no more. The doctor surgery I go to. I asked him because he is one of those Indians that were from Uganda and was kicked out by Idi Amin. And I said to him, I didn't ask him about Suella Braverman, this woman, but the last one, Home Secretary, was Priti Patel, this woman here. By the way, one of the brothers in our camp said he's already said that in the kingdom, this is going to be his concubine. Hey, that's his choice, you know, because she is. She's quite pretty. But she's a coconut as well, you know. She said, she was the Home Secretary, all right, and she basically pushed this narrative that we are being swamped by immigrants and this, that, and the other. It's sad, man. You know, they're doing the master's bidding for them. They put black and brown people in positions where they could push racist rhetoric. All right. And because they're black and brown, people can't say, oh, it's not racist, you know, and many white commentators, political commentators were saying that they were saying, well, Priti Patel and this woman, Suella Braverman, who was the last Home Secretary, can't be racist because they're Indian and brown themselves. OK, so that's the background of this. All right. And they called those Palestine marches hate marches, which they're not. And there was hardly any trouble at those marches. White people are there, even Jewish people are there, all people are there. But they called it hate marches. And this woman had a placard showing their faces and said that they are coconuts. And they arrested her for it. And she lost her job and everything. So that's the background to it.
And asylum seekers, many condemned as racist. In response, Mariah Hussein drew this placard that some may find offensive.
It's not offensive.
Mariah Hussein told the court that the image was political satire that she made to criticize the inflammatory language of the then Home Secretary.
Yep.
The prosecution said that that placard had crossed the line from free speech into hate speech. The prosecution had even cited this.
Now she wants to be known as black.
Donald Trump being condemned for questioning the ethnicity of Kamala Harris was referenced as support for why the placard crossed the line. It was at this point that the defense barrister stood up and said, you've got to be joking. Earlier this year, the Black Police Association had told Channel 4 News they were concerned that policing was being politicized at the expense of racial minorities. The court had heard how today's case was the result of a complaint on X, right-wing blog based in Washington with pro-Israel interests.
Rubbish.
In court, an expert witness cited this BBC programme titled Coconuts to highlight how the term was often explored by racial minority communities, sometimes even to describe or critique their own political and cultural identity. The court heard that criminalising the term is setting a dangerous precedent. The court heard that the intra-communal language amongst black and brown minorities was now being held to a higher standard than other groups who had their own expression to describe political and cultural differences among them. It is this that has led to backlash against the CPS decision to charge Mariha Hussein. At the first hearing, protesters were arrested for holding up coconuts in support.
Yeah, look at that.
Today the court had heard
crazy.
That the Metropolitan Police had sought expert advice from Professor Kehinde Andrews to understand the events. And in response, he made this video.
If I call you a coconut, is it a crime? No, of course not.
In a twist, Professor Andrews is now being investigated for that video.
But wow.
How do you, as a anti-racist campaigner, find yourself in a position where you're justifying use of an insult that people say is racialized?
Who says it's racialized? These terms, coconut, these come from struggle. They come from us. The whole point of this is to say, you can't tell me I should be proud to have a brown prime minister and a brown home secretary and then say, well, actually, when they do things which are racist, we can't criticize them. That's what it is. This is political language, and the judge made it very clear. This is political satire.
It is unclear what impact today's verdict will have on those cases.
Yeah.
What has been revealed are the inconsistencies and challenges the authorities have in recognizing when a racial offence has been committed.
Yeah.
These add further questions over how the political speech of minorities is policed from those who say the decision to prosecute was coconuts.
There you see. So that's the background to it, man. So now they want to arrest people for using the word coconuts. Well, sorry, I'm not gonna stop using that word coconuts. That's one of my favorite terms for you niggers, man. All right, for you coconuts that actually love the so-called white man. All right, you know. And I'm glad, man. The Lord, hey, the Bible says man's goings off the Lord. So the Lord put the spirit on the judge to say this is bullshit, and she won that case. Okay. But that, you know what, when I saw that thing, it reminded me of our people, because you know why? You've been so, we as a nation have been so ground down that you actually believe and think, like there was a video of this black girl in the university and she freaked off with a white guy and she actually went on YouTube or social media and told everything that happened, and she said while the guy was fucking her, she could see that he didn't like her. He you know, he didn't even want to look her in the eye. He was just banging the life out of her. Yeah, because he looked at you as lesser than. All right, you were just a piece of ass. That's all. And but that's how small our people have lowered themselves. All right, because of the condition that we're in. All right. So what is the solution of our people being, and by the way, the ones of our people that you have this coconut coon mentality, you're going to be put to death, man. All right. You're going to be put to death. The Lord is not going to be with you, man. Okay. All right. Let's get our first scripture, because we always have to edify. And this is prophecy. It's prophecy, man. Is prophecy that our people would have a slave coconut mentality. Okay. Alright. Alright. This is Jeremiah 2:14. Is Israel a servant? Alright. And what is a servant, man? A servant is someone that's serving someone. Alright. And aren't we serving our enemies for want of all things? Alright. And it goes on to say what? Is he a homeborn slave? Home-born slave, all right? A home-born slave, man, all right? Being on a plantation, you know? Your mom got breeded up like animals, because they did breed our people like animals, man. They actually did that, man. Go watch that, what's that film? Goodbye, Uncle Tom. They had breeding farms where they bred our people like animals, man. And you see the 12-year-old girl and she's been broken in by some Jake that has mental illness, man. And she's screaming her eyes out. All right. And then that baby 9 months later comes out born on a dirty plantation. That's what a homeborn slave is. All right. And in and mentally, unfortunately, many of our people are like that. So is Israel a servant? Is he a homeborn slave? Question mark. All right. So the 2/3 of our people in America, Zechariah 38, that are predestined to be put to death, a lot of them are homeborn slaves. You know, they care about their master and their master's welfare rather than their own people. All right. And then it goes on to say, why is he spoiled? And what does spoil mean? When you spoil something, you take, it's like you take it away. And what has happened to us? We've had what taken away from us? What has been taken away from us? Our language, our heritage, everything. Our history has been whitewashed. That's why I'm big on history. That's why I love history, man. And that's why I will always encourage, whether it be my channel or whether it be other channels on YouTube, you know, our people should always go and explore the real history. Because as I said, the Middle Ages, we ruled that, our history in Israel, the ancient world, and in other kingdoms as well, man. And that's why on this channel, I put When Israelites Ruled Europe, a one playlist just of 1,000 years of our history, man. All right. And when you watch these videos, all right, you know, all these are facts. And these are things that the white man, the elites, have tried to basically hide, you know. They've tried to hide all of these things, you know. They've whitewashed everything. So Moses is white. The Messiah is white. King James is white. Oh, King James is a homosexual and white. You know, according to them, William Shakespeare was white. These are all lies. And what does that do? When you don't know lies, they rob you. They take away your self-worth and your value. That's why videos like this is very important. You know, the Moors. Who was the Moors? It was our people. All right. Christian Moors, Muslim Moors. 1,000 years of our people rule in Europe, you know, but white people don't know because they whitewash things. So that's why it's very important to get this history, to know that William Shakespeare was a black man, to know that he was one of us, to know that we have Islamic kingdoms, to know Charlemagne, you know, the Christian kingdom, to know mostly, to know who you are and to know that your Lord and Savior, Haoshai, looked like you, dark as you. All right. It's very, very important. So that's the reason why we have been robbed and spoiled, man. All right. All right. Is Israel a servant, homeborn slave? Why is he spoiled? Now, let's look up the word spoiled in Hebrew.
H 957.
Yep.
Baz.
All right. Spoil, booty, robbery. And that's what they've done. They've robbed everything from us. All right. They've robbed everything from us. But that was prophecy, because the Bible said what? We would discontinue from our heritage, Jeremiah 7 and 4. All right. So what you have to understand is that there's a reason why many of our people are coconuts, man. And that's why the Bible says what? To be transformed. Let's get that scripture. All right. All right. To be transformed by what? The renewing of your mind, man. All right. Because having all of these things taken away has had a devastating effect on our people. All right. Hosea 4:6. Let's get that first. My people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge. All right. And that's the reason why they become coconuts. That's the reason why, because they always try to defend the person that is in power. And who's in power? So-called white man, the Edomites. Because thou hast rejected knowledge, I also shall reject thee. So the ones who are people that don't care about their nationality, you know, who they are, the Lord is going to reject you. And that's why he's going to put you to death. That thou shalt be no priest to me. So you won't be a part of the elect. Because the elect is going to be, we are going to be like a kingdom of priests. We're going to be judging the other nations in righteousness using the laws that are in the Bible. All right, and that's where the new covenant comes in. All right, Jeremiah 31 and 30. Okay. All right, seeing that you have forgotten the law of your God, of your power, all right, I also forget thy children. And that's why our people's children are being put to death, you know. That's the reason why our people are coconuts, man. So, you know, I put just on Google Bible verses about self-hatred, you know, and I had to do it. And it came out with a few scriptures, all right, you know. But there's hope because, you know, if you're a coconut, you need to repent, man, all right? You need to repent. And basically, being a coconut is about fear. You fear, all right, being at odds with the race that has brutalized you, all right? You're scared of them, so you bow down and acquiesce to them because they're in power, and, you know, and that's the reason why. It's all about fear, okay? It's all about fear, all right? Okay, and sadly, it's a lack of faith as well. When you don't know your power, you grab on. It's just like a woman, you know? A lot of these women, they go out, you know, looking for men, and they go out looking for a man with a lot of money. But they are, but in particular, they don't care how this man gets his money. So he's on the street, he's doing wicked stuff, he's being a nigger, like Rich Homie Quan, you know, all these niggers and stuff. You know, they go out with these guys. You know why? Because they fear that they can't do things on their own. And you know what that is? A lack of confidence. A lack of confidence comes from a lack of knowledge. Alright? That's what it comes down to, man. Alright? And the Lord didn't make mistakes. Okay? When he made us, man. Okay? Alright? This is Ephesians 5 and 29. For no man ever yet hated his own flesh. You're not supposed to hate the way you look. Your own flesh. The Lord didn't make no mistakes when he designed you. Okay? He didn't make no mistakes when he designed you. If people make comments about you, if you're dark skinned and, you know, oh, you're black as this. My cousin, she texted me today and messaged me and said, how are you today? But I remember growing up, because my mum's side of the family, they're quite brown and that. And she used to go, oh, you're black, you're ugly like your dad, this, that, and the other. You know, she made it as a joke. But no, she meant that, man. Because my dad was really, really dark skinned, and so am I, you know. And those things can knock your confidence, man. And it did me. But guess what? You know, because I'm in this truth, and I know that even my maker is dark, Yahweh Shai is super dark. You know, I'm proud of who I am. I'm proud of how the Lord's made me. All right? So, Ephesians 5:29, for no man ever yet hated his own flesh, but nourisheth it and cherish it, even as the Lord... even as the Lord, the church, because the Lord, the Heavenly Father, he nourishes us with this word. All right. So we're not supposed to hate our own flesh. You know, we're not supposed to hate the way we look, you know, and, you know, the scripture is more or less, you know, is talking about, a spiritual nourishing of the word. But you can apply that to how the Lord has made you. You know, if you, it's different. If you have a deformity or stuff like that, we know, or a medical condition that makes you a bit deformed or whatever, you know, like today I was watching a documentary about Gary Coleman. Remember him from Different Strokes? You know, the reason why he looked like a child and very small, and he only grew to 4'8", is because he had kidney problems, you know, and people always treated him, you know, like crap. His own parents took his money on all sorts. I really felt for him, man. He died and he was married to some white woman that didn't give two shits about him. You know? So, you're not supposed to have self-hatred for yourself, man. Alright? That's why the Bible says to be what? Be transformed. Let's get that one. Alright? It's at Romans 12. Alright? All right. Let's start with verse 1, Romans 12 and 1. I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of the Most High, that you present your bodies as a living sacrifice. So when we go out there and teach, that's what we're doing. Wholly acceptable to God, which is your reasonable service. So it's a reasonable thing that we're doing. Verse 2. And be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is good and acceptable and perfect will of God. So be transformed by the renewing of your mind, all right? I'll give you examples of this self-hatred. Remember this film? Let's watch this clip.
Fuck
this shit. Okay, let's go for it. Look at the cracker cop. He's just looking at this monkey, and he's just saying, "Wow, man, these people really are animals, man." You know. All right, the black cop was worse than the white cop, but why was he like that? Self hatred, man. All right, self hatred, and that does go back to the curses. So once you're in this truth and you understand that we're under these curses, all right, you start to understand that, listen, you know what, our people, they're not in their right mind at the moment, all right? They're not in their right mind at the moment, because remember, one of the curses is about hatred towards each other, all right? Deuteronomy 28, verse 54, all right? And it's all of them. It's not just the black man, the Latinos, Native Americans. The average Latino don't like anything that is brown. They don't like themselves. They hate themselves, man. Okay? They hate themselves. They will never accept a black so-called a black Yahweh Shai. All right? But the ones that are not going to accept it are the ones that are going to be put to death. How many Israelite groups around there, around the world, and they've got Northern Kingdom, Native Americans, all as one, man. And we know that Yahweh Shai is super dark, and we all accept it because our minds have been renewed. And it's only the Heavenly Father that can do that. It's up to Him. It's His will. So Deuteronomy 28 and 54. So that the man that is tender among you, all right, and very delicate. So at one time, our people used to be tender and delicate towards each other, all right. His eye shall be evil towards his brother. So that's the reason why we have high murder rates and stuff, you know. Etc. Black and black crime, Latinos killing Latinos, Native Americans. Oh, Native Americans gang banging on the res. Here it is, you're on a barren piece of land and you're killing your own people on the reservation. It's incredible, man. That's how you know it's a curse that's on us. All right. His eye shall be evil towards his brother and towards the wife of his bosom. That's why relationships don't work. And toward the remnant of his children, which he shall leave. All right. So no one can say that this Bible's not about us. That's why we have single mothers. Okay. All right. And this is another, this is just a good small example of self-hatred. Now I'm going to give you one more clip because I thought this is quite permanent in the, and then we're going to put this lesson to a close. This is one of, and you know what, you can criticize the guy, you know when you hear this, but it's his experiences in our community. All right, how people treat you when you're darker. Okay.
Crazy. Something like that. Are you on that?
I ain't gonna lie. What'd he say? I'm already black. I don't need no black.
Right, that's what he said.
So yeah, I ain't gonna lie. I can't have no cut. Like, I know if I'm black, right? I'm black.
Yeah, black is beautiful, though, man.
So I know if I'm black, we're gonna have a black baby.
So?
I ain't with that.
What?
Cause I'm already black.
So?
No!
Well, I mean, this is an interesting thing. You know what I mean? Like,
wow.
So if you have a baby, you don't want your baby to be the same complexion as you?
Mm-hmm.
What?
It's a once in a lifetime thing.
What do you mean?
Like, it's a dark shade. Hell nah. I can't have.
Is your mom same shade as you?
Nah.
She's like,
hell nah. I'm like caramel mocha.
Okay, so your dad is darker.
Yeah.
Okay. Mm,
see?
And
you know the reason why he's saying that is because of his experiences. So we can be very, you can pounce on him, be judgmental, but it's his experiences, man. It's his experiences, you know, and that's on our people. So, hey, guess what, man, you know, it's just like even my sister's about the same complexion as me. I've got two sisters, the one that's a couple years older than me, okay, same complexion as me. And sometimes a couple of years ago, and you know, it was summer, it was darker. It was really hot, and you know, I was, out in the sun, and I got darker than usual, and she's making comments about it, man, you know, but you know why? Because they're destroyed for lack of knowledge, it's self-hatred, man, and their minds are not renewed, so they're just gonna die hating themselves, you know. All right, so I'm not gonna get on this guy because he's a rapper and so forth, you know, and I think he's Haitian, so he's from the tribe of Levi, you know. See, that's why what that woman did with the trial, she was basically showing that, you know, even in the Asian community, Elamites, they're called in the Bible, they have coconuts among them, all right? Coconuts among them that love the white man, okay? All right, there was one, what's her name? I'll just try and show it to you. Narinda. Yeah, Narinda, coconuts. I think it's her. She made a jibe talking about Rishi Sunak. And by the way, this woman here, this presenter here, her name's Nana Okoya. She's an Israelite woman. She's an absolute disgrace, man. She is a coconut, man. All right, she's an absolute coconut, man. All right, and there's a far right party. There's a far right party in the UK called Reform, and many people are voting for them. All right, and listen to what she says. Now, this is an Elamite woman as well. Listen to what she says, and what she says is absolutely right. You know, but listen to what she said, man. She used that same term, coconuts. You know.
Reform were racist. They're really not. I know Nigel quite well, and hopefully in the not-too-distant future we'll get him on the show. And I've known him for a long, long time. It was not racist. It was built with cocaine smuggling.
Diane was shot dead and killed. When we've got Mariah Hussein saying coconut, you can't say coconut, and she's being criminalised. We've got a two-tier keeping system here.
Right, okay. Narinda, thank you very much.
But let me finish.
Go on, then.
There is a racism problem in Labour, but it's more and more obvious in the Reform Party.
I say it's not all of them at all, I can assure
you. I'm not apologising, and I'll tell you why. Because what the phone calls are doing,
let's be honest. Tell that one to shut up. She or he is not on the show.
People have colour vote reform, lots of people.
You know, Nigel, hang on, listen.
That coconut.
I have
coconuts.
racist, I don't want to
raise racist.
No, she, no.
See, she said people, the guy said people of colour vote for reform, which is a far right party. It is a far right party. And you know what she said? She goes, yeah, they do. And they're coconuts. What was their reaction? Get her off. She's racist. You know, see, this man is trying to reverse things and say that we're racist. That's why that trial, that coconut trial, was an absolute waste of time. Absolute waste of time. And it's just a so-called white man standing on his soapbox trying to act out like other people are racist when he's the main one that is racist, man. Look at their history, man. It tells you. So what are you going to get out of having this coconut coon mentality? You're going to try and get love from people that don't love you. All right. They have what? A perpetual hatred for us. All right. So it's time to come back. It's time for your mind to be renewed, man. All right. And basically, it's all about fear. You fear that if you go against your master, all right, you ain't going to eat. You ain't going to have a job. You know, you ain't. Oh, I better have a white man because I want my kids to come out light. This is all self-hatred, man. Okay. What does the Bible tell you about this stuff? All right. The Bible tells you that the people that have this mentality are totally lost. All right. This is 2 Timothy 1:7. For the Most High have not given us the spirit of fear. See, you fear going against your oppressor and your master. You know why? Because the Bible, remember, the Bible did say, part of the curses is that we'll go to our enemies for the want of all things. So you fear that, man. All right. You fear that. All right. But what does the Bible say? It says God has not given us the spirit of fear. All right, but of power and of love. He loves us, man. And you should love yourself no matter how dark you are, whether you're short, tall, you know, fat, thin, or whatever, you know. And there's things that if you are a bit overweight or whatever, you can lose that weight, man. But don't start bleaching your skin and doing that to try and get closer to looking like the white man's ideal. And any of our people that have that same mentality, they're lost. All right, but of power, of love, and of sound mind. All right, basically, you coconuts haven't got a sound mind. You have a self-hatred problem. That's all it comes down to, man. All right, okay. The Lord created us in His own image, man. Okay, we are the royal line. Okay, and that's something that you should be valued, man. All right. And it comes down to this, the way you can start, all right, if you are a coconut and you're watching this, one of the ways you can start to heal is to do this, all right, to confess your sins, man, all right, go on your knees, lift your hands up, face the east, as it tells you in Daniel chapter 6 and 18, all right, and here it says 1 John 1:9, if we confess our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive us our sins. Ask the Lord for forgiveness, man. All right. Saying that you've been favoring a race of people that hate you over your own people. All right. He is faithful and just to forgive our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. And it is unrighteous. And there was a play that is on in America. All right, and I saw it a news clip of it today.
4 million voted reform were racist. They're really
They are racist. You piece of shit, man. All right, this one, and this is a play, and it tackles some tough issues, man. In fact, it's about a, it was based on a film as well. So I'm going to play it here. All right. But there's one bit in there where it talks a little bit about the self-hatred that I went on in the army, man.
Smoke generating company stationed here before transfer to Europe was brutally shot to death.
Captain Davenport's authority is immediately questioned.
May I speak freely?
You haven't stopped yet, Captain.
How far do you think you could get?
And by the way, this is a based upon a true story, this play, man. Apparently it was a film, and this film, Denzel Washington was in it. Let me go forward a bit, all right?
To stage a soldier's play. It starred Adolf Caesar and a young Denzel Washington and Samuel L. Jackson, who embodied roles familiar to the playwright.
Humans are, if anything, not perfect. And so, having been in the army with a lot of nuts and great guys, I met all sorts of people that could always look back to find the character that I needed in the story.
The 1984 film A Soldier's Story was nominated for 3 Oscars, including Best Picture.
I'm gonna watch that.
Anything you don't want to do, the colored troops will do for you.
The murder mystery exposes the disrespect black soldiers endured from whites and each other.
See?
Time to teach you a lesson.
Yeah, what he said, whites and each other, you see? So that's why there has to be a separation. There's going to have to be, they're going to have to be the Lord saving some of our people, a small remnant of our people, which is the elect, and he has to get rid of the majority of them. Because if we have a king, when we have our own kingdom on this earth, can you imagine if people in that kingdom have this self-hatred, coconut, Sambo mentality, the men and the women, it's not going to work. All right, while we're brutalizing the heathens who deserve to be brutalized, because remember, they lynched us, burned us, hanged us, they destroyed our history, you know, they've even stolen children, molesting children. These are crimes that are unforgivable, man. All right, but if we have a kingdom and we're going to be at the top, and we're going to be brutalizing these heathens, especially the so-called white people. If we have people in that kingdom who are coconuts, they're going to spoil the program, all right? We won't be able to, we won't be able to conduct the kingdom in a righteous manner. Remember what the Bible says, all right? What does it say? Can two walk together? You know, and that's true. Can two walk together except they be agreed? All right, and that's the beauty about the elect. The elect is going to be in one body, is going to be in one mindset, the mindset of Yahweh Bashem Yahu Shai. All right, Amos chapter 3, verse 3. Can two walk together except they be agreed? All right, so you have to make your decision, man. You have to make decision. Okay, you have to make your decision, and basically it comes down to the fact that the Lord knows who he wants and who he doesn't want, you know, and he gave us the law, statutes, and commandments. So this is the reason why he's punished us sternly and rightfully so. Okay, all right, let's go back. Let me go to Amos 3:1. Actually, Amos 3:1, hear this word that the Lord has spoken against you, O children of Israel. So this is the Lord speaking against us, against the whole family which I brought up from the land of Egypt, saying, and remember, the whole family was both the northern and the southern kingdom. We were all together, all 12 tribes were all slaves in Egypt. All right. So against the whole family which I brought up from the land of Egypt, saying, all right. Verse 2, you only have I known of all the families of the earth. See, so the Lord has only known us, all right? He doesn't deal with these other nations, all right? Look at the conclusion. Therefore, I will punish you for all your iniquities, all your sins upon sins, all right? Verse 3, Amos 3:3, can two walk together except they be agreed, all right? So we can't agree with you coconuts. You coconuts want to kiss your master's ass. Meanwhile, we want to chop the master's head off. We can't agree. All right, so make your choice, man. All right. So listen, man, I hope you were edified. And in the next lessons, as I said, I'm going to be doing the breakdown of Ezekiel 38. You know, it's going to be two or three videos in that. And it's going to be based upon World War III, man. And World War III will be in our homeland. It will be world wars. It will be around the world. But it will be mainly concentrated in our homeland. Ezekiel 33 and 38 goes into that. So stay tuned. So I pray you were edified. Until the next one, Shalom.